Hey, Bodina, come here. Bodina, tell him, what are we going to do?
You're going to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
I'm going to rip his heart out. I'm the best ever. I'm the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champion there's ever been. I want your heart. I want to eat his children. Praise be to Allah.
Boxing's heavyweight division is the source of the greatest sports icons, but two stood head and shoulders above the rest, Mike Tyson and Muhammad Ali. Iron Mike made a name for himself with his unbelievable hand speed and violent power. Muhammad Ali had an unparalleled swagger and the game in the ring to back it up. Who would win if these two giants faced off? Well, keep watching to find out as we reveal the scary truth of power versus speed. Before we begin, it's important to state that Mike Tyson and Muhammad Ali never fought. Ali's last non-exhibition fight was in 1981, while Tyson's first professional fight didn't take place until 1985. Two fighters, Trevor Burbick and Larry Holmes, fought them both, although Tyson and Ali never actually got in the ring. Therefore, who would have won such a fight remains in the realm of speculation. That said, let's dive right in. Now, boxing is a sport that has created superstars. If there is any sport that can claim to have created Superman or Supermen, it is boxing, and more specifically, the heavyweights. In 1978, DC Comics released a comic in which heavyweight champion Muhammad Ali took on Superman, unsurprisingly titled Muhammad Ali vs. Superman, and all we know is Ali was a global superstar. He even called himself the Black Superman on a song he made. In the sporting world, none can compare to Ali's name and fame except for one man, the baddest man on the planet, Iron Mike Tyson. Another heavyweight boxing champion of the world, and most likely the most entertaining and explosive fighter the world of combat sports has ever seen. There has never been another fighter across all combat sports who was as intimidating as Iron Mike was in his prime. One of the often asked questions among boxing fans has been the age-old question, who would win if Muhammad Ali fought against Mike Tyson? When considering Muhammad Ali at his best, we're going to pick the period just before he was banned from boxing for refusing to be drafted into the US military. So this is the Ali who fought against the likes of Zora Foley, Ernie Terrell, and Cleveland Williams, although we will take into account his whole career. A peak Mike Tyson would be the Tyson from before the Buster Douglas defeat. This, in our opinion, is both boxers at their absolute best, but again, we will look at their careers as a whole. So here is our rundown of Float Like a Butterfly, Sting Like a Bee against I Want to Eat Your Heart and I Want to Eat Your Children. Styles. Muhammad Ali was fast. He liked to fight on the outside, flicking his jab at you, keeping you at range. Due to his shorter height for his division, Mike Tyson was a master of evading and countering the jab. Ali fought men such as former heavyweight champion Floyd Patterson, who were similar to Tyson. Patterson was trained in the peekaboo style by Tyson's mentor and trainer Custamato, and Ali dispatched Floyd Patterson pretty easily both times. However, it must be added Patterson is no Tyson, and was past his prime on both occasions. Age 30 in the first bout and 37 in the second, which incidentally would be his last. Tyson at times struggled against boxers who would stick and move, and his head movement would slow as the fight wore on. Ali's reach advantage would give Tyson the kind of problems he faced in the James Tillis and Buster Douglas fight, not to mention against Holyfield and Lewis later on in his career. Guys who utilized the jab could move and also tie you up as Ali would do to Tyson. When it comes to styles, Ali gets the nod. Tyson has the advantage of his great hooking ability. Ali at times lowered his punching hand, such as when throwing the uppercut. It is a distinct possibility this is something Tyson would capitalize on, perhaps even better than Joe Frazier did. Power. There really isn't any comparison here. Ali was not a puncher. Tyson would kill you early. He had plenty of first round knockouts. Can anyone even name a fight Ali won in the first round? We don't think there's ever been a more explosive puncher in boxing. Certainly not the heavyweights at least, than Mike Tyson. But here's the problem with this argument, and the problem is Ali's chin. Ali was only knocked down 4 times in his whole career. He took on the biggest punchers the heavyweight world has ever seen. George Foreman, Ernie Shavers, Sonny Liston, none of them managed to knock Ali down, let alone knock him out or beat him. So why would anyone think Tyson would be able to knock out Ali? This leads me nicely to the next point. Mental strength. Tyson was vicious, no mistake about it. He was one man you would hate to get in a fight with, both inside or outside the ring. He often beat his opponents before the fight through sheer intimidation, but if he couldn't bully you, he would struggle to impose his will, especially if the fight wore on and went into the later rounds. On the other hand, Ali was the first to really employ psychological tactics against his opposition. Sonny Liston was the most feared man in boxing with links to the mafia and multiple stints in prison. Yet Ali stood firm and embarrassed him. Joe Frazier was so upset with Ali's jibes that he didn't really ever forgive Ali. The use of Ollie's tactics outside the ring in the lead up to the fight goes on and on. No boxer could outsmart Ollie. Tyson was a loose cannon at the best of times. If he had to put up with Ollie's taunts, he would go into the fight wanting to kill Ollie and throw his plan out the window, which would fall right into Ollie's hands. When considering mental strength, you also have to take into account how a fighter responds when he is dragged deep into the fight, or deep waters as some would say. Would he drown or swim to the finish line? Ollie was involved in wars, most notably the Thriller in Manila against Joe Frazier, but Ollie was no stranger to lasting the distance and going deep into a fight. Tyson, on the other hand, if he couldn't get you out of there early, would often slow down, lose his head movement, and noticeably be far less dangerous. Did Mike Tyson ever come from behind to win a fight? Ollie came off the canvas to win fights, Spanks and Cooper, and he could continue to mix it up even after an injury like the broken jaw suffered against Ken Norton. When it came to mental strength and the desire to dig deep, the heart and will to win, Ollie was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest. You also have to remember the Cus-D'Amato argument. People say Tyson always had Cus in his corner. He would have been the best. Still, this reliance on Cus works against him when it comes to mental strength, especially when you consider Muhammad Ali beat Jimmy Ellis. Ali's famed trainer, Angelo Dundee, wasn't in his corner for this fight, but in Jimmy Ellis's corner. Competition. Ali ruled the roost in heavyweight boxing during its golden era. Liston, Foreman, and Frazier were all-time greats in the heavyweight division. Ali beat them 5 out of 6 times. Not to mention other high-quality fighters such as Ken Norton, Ron Lyle, Ernie Shavers, Floyd Patterson, and Archie Moore. Moore is an all-time great too, just not at the heavyweight division. And much of this came at a time Ali was already past his best. Can you name one great fighter Tyson beat? The great fighters he came up against, Lewis and Holyfield, Tyson wasn't able to win. You could also argue that when Tyson was at his best, there just weren't any other great heavyweights around. Tyson dispatched off the rest with ease. He can only beat whoever is put in front of him. Holmes was also well past his best when Tyson knocked him out. There are also rumors that Tyson's team avoided Tim Witherspoon and that Tyson wanted no part of George Foreman. The latter would make sense. Tyson's style was all wrong to fight someone like Foreman. If it is true, it was a wise decision on his part to avoid him. The same could be said of Ali. Yes, he beat Foreman in the legendary Rumble in the Jungle. Still, there was no chance Ali would want to participate in a rematch with Foreman, but looking at the list of names on their resumes, Ali had by far the tougher schedule, and still came out on top in both the 60s when he was in his peak, and in the 70s when he was past his prime. When you compare the fighters from the rounds fought perspective, things get worse for Mike. Muhammad Ali fought 56 fights, and Mike Tyson fought 58 fights. Muhammad Ali fought in 541 rounds, while Mike Tyson only fought in 211. That's an astounding 330 round difference, or the equivalent of 27.5 more 12 round fights from Muhammad Ali. That experience simply can't be discounted. Either way, it will be a very long time before we see a greater heavyweight than Ali. If you combine his ring craft with his personality, we will possibly never see another boxer of his kind able to make such an impact across the globe. The same can be said for Iron Mike Tyson. Will we ever see someone younger than Tyson was at just 20 claim the World Heavyweight Championship? Will there ever be another fighter as explosive and exciting as Mike Tyson? We're gonna let you decide.